a white female kidnaps, duct tapes, and stabs a black male during a Tinder date. Let's put a picture up full throttle here. All right. She could be incarcerated right now for murder. Let me give you the background as to what happened. According to the police, Colorado, a Colorado woman decided to duct tape, stab a 21-year-old black male Tinder date. She orders DoorDash while he bled. The victim barely escaped with his life. The officers arrested Lauren Marie Dooley and charged her with second-degree kidnapping, a class 3 felony, 2 counts of assault in the second degree, a class 4 felony, menacing, a class 5 felony, and false imprisonment, a class 2 misdemeanor. According to WKRC, Dooley appeared in an El Paso County court on Thursday, October 6th. I have significant background to this extreme story. The victim was 21 years of age, a black male who met his attacker on the popular dating app. A Colorado woman has now been charged with multiple felonies after she allegedly brutally assaulted her Tinder date. The 22-year-old is accused of stripping him naked, duct taping him, choking him, and slicing him up with a knife before she ordered something to eat on DoorDash. The victim took advantage of an opportunity to plot his escape and live to tell the tale. The person told the dispatcher he or she could hear someone saying, "Because you cut me and you're going to kill me," and said he was bleeding all over the bed. They wrote, upon arrival, residents at the apartment advised there was a naked male in the parking lot. This is when he escaped. That needed help. Officers located, and we've redacted his name, who was naked and appeared to be bleeding from a laceration on his left arm. Name redacted, also actively backing away from the suspect, identified via a law enforcement database as Lauren Dooley, date of birth 6/2/2000, who appeared to have blood smeared on her arms and hands. I already know some people are going to ask and push back on why did I redact and why have I not proposed the individual's name who's a victim. Here's why, because he's also a victim of sexual assault. I don't give a damn what the charges say. If this was a female in the same position, I would do the exact same thing. Even though she is not charged with sexual assault, this is a sexual assault case in my opinion. So I would treat it as such on this broadcast. There's more information. The report continued, name redacted, exclaimed that Lauren tied him up and cut him. Lauren was detained but invoked her Miranda rights and refused to speak with me. The officer said the young man did not know the young woman for long but still went to her house. There's more. They sat on Lauren's couch and talked a bit. Lauren then proceeded to take clothing off and perform oral sex on him, according to the report. She then used duct tape to bind him, name redacted, wrists together and ankles together. The man said that despite finding it odd, he still consented. Now let me just pause right here, okay? This is your first time meeting somebody. This is already a weird situation. I'm saying this as a public service announcement to anyone who has their first encounter with somebody, please, for the sake of all things holy, do not allow them to completely make you vulnerable to attack, okay? If you get down like that, you get down like that. I have no issue with that. But damn it, at least know who the person is. This situation happened. This man is now completely vulnerable to whatever attack she decided to bring to him. And that's exactly what she did. It can't be that serious, fellas, is my point. All right. However, when Lauren produced a knife and demanded he gets into her bedroom, he no longer consented to staying at the residence. That's when it became a sexual assault. Okay, this is when it goes into this level. Because he was afraid, he got into her bed and let her climb on top of him. She then proceeded to use the knife to cut his left shoulder and then use both hands to apply direct pressure to his throat for roughly 20 seconds. making it difficult for him to breathe. Lauren stopped, but only to procure a belt that she then placed around the young black male's neck. The second half of the affidavit, let's put it up, because I want you to know we have the full affidavit here of everything that has been highlighted in evidence and testimony. Dooley then tells the victim to get into the bathtub and bathe. Okay? While he was in the tub, she ordered food on DoorDash. Once her order came, before he opened the door, she turned to her date and said, "If you scream or say anything, I'll kill you." After eating the food, she took her date, quote unquote, and went back into her bed, covering him with a blanket. As the young man gets into the bed with her, he notices the knife she used to stab him is underneath the cover near his feet. At some point, Dooley falls asleep, and then he grabs the knife and attempts to free himself, cutting the duct tape. She falls asleep because torture is exhausting. She ate DoorDash, she's torturing, she falls asleep. Once free, he tried to get his keys and his phone to get out of the apartment, but accidentally bumped into a table. The noise from the bump woke Dooley up, but the victim did not stop to engage her. He ran into the parking lot, demanded help, and was met by police officers. He had no clothes on during this time. This is a hell of a story. So obviously, this story is still developing. She invoked her Miranda rights. She is not talking. We have no statement on the record from why this person did this monstrous thing according to the allegation. But please, please, everyone, let this serve as a reminder. You can't simply go head first into everybody's home and trust them without some level of fence or barrier around that relationship. People should earn that level of trust. Now, I know some people will make jokes about this segment. Some people will talk about how he liked it at first and whatever. Let's be 100. You won't like to be in this situation. You don't want your children to be in this situation. People that you love, you won't want them to be in this situation. It's a bad situation. So we're gonna highlight this story, stay on top of it. And hopefully at some point we'll understand the motive behind this extreme behavior of this criminal who kidnapped a human being and damn near killed him. All right, Rickey, thoughts on this?
You know, Dr. Richey, thank you for having me again. This is another level of freaky dicky is back.
Yeah. Yes.
And like you said, going into situations like that head first could be dangerous. Like, you just can't do anything, you know, and put yourself in a predicament where you just walk in the house and you're dealing with the next up and coming female version of Jeffrey Dahmer.
Yep.
That's what it sound like. And you know, the DoorDash, I mean, and you said that torturing somebody being tortured is exhausted, and she's sleepy. Now she's sleepy, and he was able to take the knife and cut himself loose. She should get life in prison, should never be able to see the light of day again. And I hope that she do get a sexual assault charge along with the kidnapping, attempted murder, menacing, and false imprisonment. She should never get out of jail again. Even if she lose, not able to walk again, she should never see the light of day, because those are small signs of something that could be really dangerous. And she could have killed him. And Lord knows that she beat this case or her privilege, get her out or whatever, she might do it again to somebody else. But
yeah,
careful out there on the dating scene.
Damn right. And listen, it's pretty conclusive that this was planned by how things worked out. You got to think about it. She had all of the material there. She engaged in intentional actions, and she decided to do exactly what she did. It was her volition that landed her here.